Is Dennis Schroder now willing to come off the bench? It appears that way. Heading into the season for the Los Angeles Lakers, Schroder had made it very clear that he wanted to be in the starting lineup, that he had spent time coming off the bench with the Oklahoma City Thunder, and he did not want to do that anymore. But now it appears he has walked back those statements and is now okay with taking on a bench role. I'm Trevor Lane for LakersNation.com. Make sure you subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. And don't forget to join our Flick chat. You can find the link in the description down below. It's a ton of fun. We're talking Lakers all day, every day over on the Flick app. All right, so Dennis Schroder had made it known he wanted to be a starter, and it was very clear why. He is in the final year of his contract, and he wants to make sure he gets starter money. And in order to do that, well, you've got to be a starter. And you have to admit, his talent level is very, very high. He is certainly talented enough to be a starter, so totally understandable why he would want to be in the starting lineup. Now, why was this even a question? Because for the Lakers, they didn't really have a true standard point guard in their starting lineup last season. LeBron James was, for all intents and purposes, their point guard, and the two starting guards were always more 3-and-D shooters. Danny Green, Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, and Avery Bradley were typically filling those roles of the two starting guard spots. So this was a shift this season to have Dennis Schroder in the starting five, and it led to a lot of questions about, might the Lakers be better off if Schroder got the bulk of his minutes with the bench unit, where they didn't have a real point guard coming in, essentially replicating the role that Rajon Rondo had with the team last season? Isn't that a greater need, to have a ball handler with that bench unit? But again, if Schroder is pushing to start, that put Frank Vogel in an interesting situation. Well, now Schroder has said that he is willing to come off the bench. Here's what he told reporters after the Lakers win against the Dallas Mavericks. "I'm a team player. Whatever it takes, what I need to do, I'm going to do it. It's team first, and we need to get some wins. Of course, I had a conversation with coach. That was my personal thing. I wanted to start this year, but I'm a team player. Whatever it takes and what I need to do and bring to the table, I will do that. I'm not worried about it at all. Whatever I can add to the games." Now, this 180 from Schroder also comes at the same time as reports that the Lakers want to extend him and would like to give him a deal come February, when they can offer him a 4-year deal at around roughly $88 million, according to Adrian Wojnarowski of ESPN. So has the fact that now it looks like the Lakers are lined up and ready to give him an extension as soon as they are able to, has that changed Schroeder's opinion here, to where now he's not as worried about his next contract and he's okay with potentially coming off the bench? Maybe that's a factor. Now, that doesn't mean that he is coming off the bench. I thought he actually played very well in the starting lineup against the Dallas Mavericks. But again, it would make a lot of sense, just in terms of fit, to have Schroder running with that bench group, particularly to combine with Montrezl Harrell. It's extremely early, but right now a higher percentage of Schroeder's passes to Montrezl Harrell become assists than any other Laker on the team. Developing the Schroder-Harrell pairing as a dynamic duo should be one of the top priorities for the Lakers. One of their main problems last season with their bench unit was their inability to score. They didn't have a go-to scoring action, and if they can get a Schroder-Harrell pick and roll going, very similar to what we saw last season with Lou Williams and Harrell with the Los Angeles Clippers, that will push their bench rotation in terms of their offensive output to a whole nother level if they have a go-to set like that Schroder-Harrell pick and roll. And we're already seeing some sparks there where those two guys can really get going on the offensive end. Now, Schroder, again, definitely has the talent to be a starter, but might the Lakers be better off with him running with the bench unit? That's going to be up to Frank Vogel to decide who would even take his spot in the starting lineup. We can certainly speculate there. It doesn't look like Vogel's going to make any changes just yet, but it is good to hear that now Schroder is willing to do this, echoing the sentiments made by Marc Gasol after the opening night loss to the Clippers. Gasol had mentioned as well that he was willing to do whatever it takes in order to win, and now Schroder is falling in line with that mentality as well. Might be an easy thing to overlook, but last season, the secret sauce behind the Lakers was their team chemistry and the willingness to sacrifice. To a man, each player was willing to do whatever it took to win, even if that meant sacrificing some of their own stats. We saw JaVale McGee, Dwight Howard benched for certain series in the playoffs, and they were cheering on their teammates as though they were out on the floor every single play. And that type of mentality is crucial to get through a long season. So it is great to hear now that Marc Gasol has already said, if need be, he's willing to come off the bench to have Schroder echo that sentiment and say he's not worried about being in the starting lineup. Will Frank Vogel make that change? We'll have to wait and see. But right now, it sounds like everybody is on board. Everybody is buying in to the Lakers and hoping that together they can bring home a second straight NBA championship. Give me your thoughts, guys. Should Schroder be moved to the bench? He's been playing great, so it certainly wouldn't be because of merit. It certainly wouldn't be that he's not playing well enough to be a starter. But in terms of their system, is he a better fit running with the bench unit? Give me your thoughts in the comments down below. Don't forget to go discuss this over on the Flick app as well. I'll be responding there directly. And make sure you're following the Lakers Nation social media accounts at Lakers Nation on Twitter and Facebook, at Lakers Nation Official on Instagram. If you want to follow me, you can find me at Trevor_Lane on Twitter, at TrevorLaneNBA on Instagram. The Lakers take on the Wolves on Sunday. I'm going to preview that in my next video, so be on the lookout for that one. Till then, see ya and stay safe.